This is Sandy with SDS Digital and the Reflex LiveLoop, and I'm going to show you a new mode, a Stutter, it's called, and just basically how to use it. It's still in the preliminary stages, but it's definitely going to be included in the next major firmware update. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to make a little loop here. This is going to be unclocked, and then I'll show you a clocked loop. So we'll go back to not clock input. I'm going to set the rate. I've got the rate set full sample rate, and I'll get a little echo going.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, I guess that's tidying up, not super good, but okay, now to get into stutter mode, you just hold the P-cell, and these two LEDs on the outside will come on. Now, the reason the blue is on here is because that indicates when you're on a larger lock area of address cycling in the memory. I'll just give that a demonstration here. On the right channel. Here it is. Now you can hear the stutter happening already. Now if I turn the other one on the left channel to it, they'll match. Okay, so the cool thing about stutter is it is left and right channels, and you can offset, and there's intermediate little greens in between each blue light flash. Now the stutter rate is really unpredictable. After a while, you kind of get to learn to use it with the rate up and down a little bit. But really, it's pretty surprise, surprise every time, so. Okay, you can see I've adjusted the left side. This is the left, this is the right. Now, this doesn't affect slices or play effects. Those still will operate normally, but I'm thinking on incorporating it into that too, but I'm not sure at this moment. So now we'll go in between markers with the left channel. Now you got all the clicking and fun stuff because there's no muting or any kind of zero crossing or anything on the RP sample play. So you can get all kinds of rhythms going. Okay, the other mode of stutter, if you just tap this while you're in stutter, tap P-cell again, takes you into fine mode, which exclusive ORs the address with whatever you're putting into the knob here. So I'll go with left channel, and you'll see what I mean. You can hear it starting to de-res a little bit. Okay, so then you can switch back out of fine, and it remains, so you can change the course setting again. Oh, So you can see you can do all kinds of really weird sounds and stuff. Sometimes it's not in sync though. It does repeat within the echo time that I created, but what's inside of it is anybody's guess, so. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to exit, and that resets everything. So it's just back to the loop, and then we'll just stop that. Now, I'm going to clock sync this, and I think I'll start off with a drum. I've already got a clock going here, but we need to add a drum to it. So I'll start echo. I don't know where it's going to end up. And we'll add drum. Drums, I guess. Okay, now I'm just going to make it go into infinite echo, but it'll stay in sync. And now I'm going to tweak it with the turn back on stutter and tweak it. That's on right channel. That's on left channel. Now if you go on to the blues, you can really hear it here. I'll get that one on a blue. See, it's more of a whole sound. There isn't any buzzing or intermediate address, dithering or twiddling or whatever you want to call it. So. You can get some really interesting rhythms, like, and it's, you know, it'll continuously go. Now, if you start echo, other weird stuff will happen. See, it's changed a bit already. Starting to pile up, so we'll turn down the feedback a bit. Render by the drums using the fine setting. Or we'll just go straight over to just that. Can do all kinds of really cool stuff to twist that sound around. Okay, so it's staying in sync because I'm feeding it into the clock. You can do it without that, but it gets a little bit crazy. What else was I going to show you? Can't remember. Okay, anyways, so... Okay, let's just go into infinite echo here. I don't know if that was a good recording. Well, okay, we still got the kind of distorted one side there, but that's okay, I guess. Okay, so I'm going to change the clock rate. Clock divider to divide by 8 from divide by 16, and then bring him back the original drum going. Now you'll hear the rate change, how differently it affects stutter. Thank you. pretty cool.
Anywho.
So there you go. That's a new stutter, and it'll be incorporated into version 1.02, which is a core update. I hope you enjoyed this video. Bye.